This video is on the topic open loop and closed loop systems. Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about the types of control systems. There are two types of control systems: open loop control systems and closed loop control systems. In open loop control systems, the output it is directly controlled by the input. So we can say that any system which is not having the feedback structure, then it will be a open loop control system. That is why the open loop control systems, they are also known as non-feedback systems. Let's take an example to illustrate the open loop control systems. This example is about the speed control of an automobile. So you can see that the input to this system is the desired speed. Desired speed means the speed which we want. There is a controller and then engine of the automobile, and the output of the engine or the system is the actual speed. So in this open loop system, there is no way in which the actual speed is controlled automatically. Okay, so the actual speed, it may be far away from the desired speed. That is, the automobile, when it is running on the road, and then the speed which we are getting, it may be different from the our desired speed. So there may be a controller which is attached in it and it is working on the engine. So the speed which we want, maybe we don't get it as an output. So this is an open loop system. Okay, and there is no feedback structure in this system so that we can have an interpret of the actual speed and we can make it close to the desired speed. So this is an example of an open loop control system. Now if we draw the generalized block diagram of an open loop control system, then how it will be? This is, let's compare it with our example. This is our input. This is our controller. The output of the controller is the control input. Now this control input, it is given to the system, and on this system there may be some disturbances which are acting on it. If the disturbances, they are produced inside the system, then they will be called internal disturbances, and there might be disturbances which are due to the external environment. So that those disturbances are known as external disturbances. So we are having a input which is known as the disturbance input. Now the signal which is coming out of the system, it is called the output of the system. So this is the way in which we can represent a generalized open loop control system. Now let's see some examples of open loop control system. Let's take examples from which we see in our daily life. Okay, so the first example of open loop control system is the electric iron which we see in our home. Remember that this electric iron is not that automatic electric iron. This is the simple electric iron, the input to which it is the power supply, and the power supply, it is connected to the electric iron, and the output of the electric iron is the heat. So it is the open loop control system. Second example is electric fan. Water tank. In water tanks, the input is the water which is getting stored in the tank, and the output is also the water. Now the water tanks, when they are filled up to the upper level, then there is no phenomena or there is no process in that we can get an indication that the water tank is full. So these are the ordinary water tanks. The next example of open loop control system is immersion heater. In immersion heater also, the output is the heating of the element, and there is no mechanism. We just apply the power supply and the heater, it gets heated up, and there is no mechanism that when it has attained the maximum temperature, then the power supply should be switched off. So this is an example of an open loop control system. So we have studied the definition of open loop control system, and we have drawn the generalized block diagram of the open loop control system, and then we studied few examples on it. Now let's study the second type of control system, which is the closed loop control system. In closed loop control system, the output has an effect on the control action of the input. That is, in the closed loop control systems, the output, it is feedback to the input. By the closed loop control system, they are also known as the feedback systems. get an example of the closed loop control system, let's take the earlier example which we have taken for the open loop control system. So let's draw the diagram for it. So in this example, the input is the desired speed, and this input, it is given to the controller, and the controller, it gives us the control input, and this control input, it is given to the engine, and engine gives us the output as the actual speed. Now this speed, it is feedback to the input by the speed sensor. The speed sensor, it senses the speed, actual speed, and a comparison is made between the desired speed and the actual speed. If the actual speed, it is less than the desired speed, then according to that, manipulations are done so that the controller, it will do some control action on the engine so that we get the desired speed as the output. Now this speed sensor, it feedbacks the actual speed to the driver's eye and the brain system. The driver looks that what speed he wants and what he is actually getting. So the brain system and the driver's eye, they are using this actual speed and comparing it with the desired speed. Now, when the driver, he has made the comparison between the actual speed and the desired speed, then he will do some control action on it, and this control action will be done by the combination of the leg muscles of the driver and the accelerator and the pedal accelerator. So the driver, he will do some changes on the leg muscles and the accelerator. He will either press it more or release it, the accelerator pedal, so that the speed will be changed. And then that manipulations will be done on the engine and we will get the desired output. So this is the example of the speed control of an automobile, or we can say that it is an example of a closed loop control system where the output, it is feedback to the input. Now let's represent the closed loop control system in a generalized way. So this is the way in which we can represent a general closed loop control system. we have an input, and this input, it is applied to the comparator, which compares the input with the feedback signal, and according to that it gives the input to the controller. Now the controller, it does some control action on the input and gives the output as the control input. This control input, it is given to the system, and the system gives us the output. Now the output which we get, it is feedback to the measurement device, or it is measured by this device, and this device will give the output as a feedback signal to the comparator. Again, the comparison is made, and according to the input, the output will be changed. Now, there are also some disturbances which are acting on the system. So, they are represented by the disturbance. These disturbances can be noise or unwanted signals which we don't want in our system. So, this is the general block diagram of a closed loop control system. Now, let's see some examples of closed loop control system. First example is voltage stabilizers. Voltage stabilizers are used in houses of many of us. So the voltage stabilizers, the first example of closed loop control system is voltage stabilizers. In voltage stabilizers, the voltage, it is regulated, that is how much voltage the device is needed, that voltage will be provided by the instrument voltage stabilizer. Okay, so the output, it is controlled by the input. The next example of closed loop control system is automatic electric iron. In automatic electric iron, the temperature which we want, we can change it by moving the knob. So in this way, we are adjusting the temperature of the electric iron. So the desired temperature which we are wanting, that is provided by the device. So this is an example of a closed loop control system. Next example is water tanks with float ball. The ordinary water tanks, we have seen that they are example of the open loop closed system. So open loop control system, because in those systems there is no process or no mechanism was present there, that when the water tank is filled, how we are going to get that information. So in water tanks which are having the float ball, the when the water tank, it is completely filled, then the float ball, it cuts the supply of water into the water tank. Okay, so there is no wastage of water. These water tanks having the float ball, they are an example of closed loop control system. So these were the examples of the closed loop control system. In this video, we have studied about the open loop control systems and closed loop control system. We have represented these systems as a general block diagram, and then we have seen some examples of open loop and closed loop control systems. So I hope that you have clearly understood the topic. Thank you.